Anderson and Andy, they host New Year's Eve.
Of course. Yeah.
So if you could recommend another show for them to host or another event to host, what would it be?
I personally want to see them host Pride.
The Grammys.
The Golden Bachelor.
Oh!
Olympic figure skating.
If you had a time machine, I'd say the eclipse.
Any show where they take a couple shots in the middle of it is a great show.
I can't believe anybody haven't said the Oscars yet.
Yeah.
Oh, the Oscars would be good.
Yeah, well, you didn't say it.
Go to happy hour after the show.
That was on the street today. So here's the question. Is there anything our guests cannot do? No, there's nothing they can't do. We're going to play a little game called Who Has More Jobs? First up, our colleague Anderson Cooper anchors two CNN shows, and you're also a 60 Minutes correspondent, so we share CBS in common.
Right.
You also host a podcast, and you've written four books.
Yes.
Not to be outdone, Andy Cohen is a host and executive producer of his own Bravo talk show, the executive producer of 14 other shows, including the Real Housewives franchise that I never watch.
Yes, you do,
Gayle. Even Andy has to laugh at that. He's a radio host. And he's written a bunch of books. Did I miss anything for the two of you? And they're both dads of two. Anderson,
really,
Andy,
what does an executive producer really do? I mean...
Just get a check.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, is that what I do?
Yeah.
Can I just say, we do a Q&A before my show every night.
Yeah.
And someone raised their hand the other day and said, would you ever consider being the Golden Bachelor?
Did they?
I was like, isn't that a little, aren't I a little young to be the Golden Bachelor?
I mean, sweetie, not really.
Okay. Hey, let me ask y'all a question.
Sweetie, not really.
The chemistry you two have.
I love it.
How many long y'all been friends?
Early 90s.
Yeah, early 90s. He had very ridiculous, he had like crazy long hair and he wore like jean short shorts. It was really, really embarrassing.
And now I have short gray hair and I wear jean short shorts.
Yes.
Yes.
So I was totally shocked today when nobody said the Oscars. They had a bunch of good ideas, but I think you guys would be great on the
Oscars.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know
either.
I don't think
would you want to do the Oscars?
That's not a real, that's not even not an option.
Yeah.
That's never going to happen.
Y'all are, like when you
I like the idea of the eclipse. That would have been fun.
That would have been very
fun. Okay. Did you guys watch the eclipse? Because I sat there. I was on a plane, number one, so I didn't see it in person. Flight attendant handed me some glasses. But I recorded three different shows, what they did on CNN,
right,
what we did on CBS, and what they did on ABC. And everybody who saw it had this deep, emotional, spiritual connection. And I sat there sitting, what's wrong with me?
I know I heard Charles talk about this. He clearly did not have an emotional reaction.
No, I did. I loved
it. Did you?
Yes.
No, Andy, that you felt like tears crying?
No.
But I'm saying that people were saying it's so emotional, it's so magical, it's so spiritual. And so I thought, what's wrong with me? Because I'm not feeling that.
I'll tell you, I got pissed because...
I know, but we saw it on television.
Well...
I brought my little son, who's 2 years old, and put glasses on, and his response was, it looks like a banana, which it did sort of look like a banana. Right. But I was pissed because... The school my four-year-old goes to, all day long they were talking about the eclipse.
Yeah.
But then I got an email from them at like 3:15 informing all parents, we are not actually going to show your child the eclipse for their own safety. I'm like, I would have taken them out of school to do that.
See it.
Right.
But did you understand why people would feel a spiritual, emotional connection?
What I felt was it was a great feeling of community.
Did you see it?
I did. Okay. And in New York City, there were people gathered on all the streets. I was on a roof, and there were people on rooftops everywhere. And it felt like a communal experience
but we didn't
and a very positive thing.
Here, they said.
It was great here, though.
Oh, it was great. You put the glasses on, you could see it. My son was. He thought it was so cool. It was beautiful.
And what did you say, Charles?
A bunch of damn losers. But I will tell
you. What did you do during the
eclipse?
I didn't even pay any attention. Now, I will admit this. If you're going to show it to a kid, I can understand that. I think it'd be great for kids.
Right.
But if you like a grown-ass person and you built your day around the eclipse, you're a damn loser.
Right.
That's just my personal opinion.
I know somebody drove all the way to Texas.
Yes.
Those are damn losers, Anderson.
But you're not going to see another one till 2044.
Which is just fine with Charles.
Like I'm good with that. I'm good with that. Like I say, I can understand kids.
The children.
High school kids, if the science teacher want to do all that stuff. Maybe if a college student was majoring in something like that. But grown folk driving places, talking about spiritual experiences and
that's
stuff.
But I felt bad because the people that saw it really felt it deeply. And I wanted to know why. Yeah, you look at the pictures. I wanted to know why I didn't feel that. Okay.
Well, did you see anything from the airplane window?
You could see it very briefly.
Okay.
Very briefly.
You know it's going to be dark.
I saw the banana.
You know it's going to be dark tonight, too.
Yeah,
right.
You go outside, it's going to be dark. Just like an eclipse out there. It's dark every day, Gayle. That's plenty of stuff.
Andy, I want to talk about Real Housewives. I was only kidding when I say I never watched, because I will text Andy. I watch it at all different times.
Very early in the morning, I will get an outreach from Gayle.
Yeah, and I'll ask him a question about something that's going on. But I heard here that Bette Midler, this is true, was very interested in being a housewife.
She tweeted that. I think it was a joke.
Did she ever reach out? She never.
No.
But if she was interested, would you want that?
Hell yes.
Yes.
Bette Midler?
Yes.
She would be the grand dame of Beverly Hills.
I want to say this, Andy. First of all, you are annoying to him, too.
No, I did not say she's annoying.
She
I
is.
Love it.
She when people text you at 4 or 5 in the morning when you're sleeping, because she feels
Who
like...
Who said I'm sleeping? My kid wakes me up at all hours. I'm happy to hear from another
person. The beauty of a text,
person.
Smarty Pants, is that you don't have to answer it.
That is correct.
No, that's why you put your phone like on silent.
No, but Gayle gets up at 3, 4 in the morning.
That's right.
And she texts the whole crew.
That's right.
And I'm like, Gayle, none of us is up, but you don't want to go to work.
You don't have to answer it, Charles.
When do you sleep? Do you really get up at 3:40?
I get up at 3:24 every day.
What time do you get up?
How'd you come up at 3:24?
Because I have a whole system, Charles, where the snooze goes off 3 times. I have a system if you don't
mind. I hate that.
If you don't mind, and then I bathe. I have a whole system. It works for me.
Yes, it does. Very well.
Let me ask you a question.
Yes, sir.
When you started this housewife thing,
yes.
You know, like, he was like, okay, I think I got a show that's going to be successful.
Right.
And obviously, it's become one of the most amazing things.
It's huge.
It's huge.
Yes. Yeah.
Did you ever have any idea where you're like, okay, let's try this?
Do you ever watch any of the housewife shows?
I do not.
Okay.
But when I'm in Atlanta.
But you understand it.
I do. Yeah.
You know,
I do.
Understand
I bumped into them in many places.
Yeah.
No, when we started The Housewives, no, we didn't. I mean, I cannot believe The Real Housewives of Orange County celebrated its 18th birthday last month.
Wow.
And I thought, wow, I remember when it premiered. Yes. My boss at the time, it was called The Real Housewives. My boss at the time said, let's call it The Real Housewives of Orange County in case we do it anywhere else.
Places,
and I thought, that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. We're not doing this show anywhere else.
Or any of the original
ones. Well, here we are. Yes.
From 18 years ago still?
Yeah, we still have some OGs.
Yes. Yeah. No, I love the friendship between the two of you because it's long-lasting, long-standing. You both have 2 young children. And the beauty is that you guys were never partners. That's what I think is so great.
We never hooked up.
No, that you were never partners. Although at first I thought you had. I thought you had. But I know that you've always been very good friends.
You thought that we had hooked up, Gayle?
Yes.
You did.
What
made you think that, out of curiosity?
Because y'all, you said y'all were close friends. Gayle, stop being nosy.
Gayle, just so you know, I never thought you and Oprah hooked up.
And we didn't.
Oh! Good job.
That's not a good job. The difference is Oprah and I are not lesbians.
That is true.
That's the difference.
That is true.
That's
Although I famously asked Oprah on Watch What Happens Live if she had ever swum in the lady pond.
Yes. And she did said, not know what that meant.
Exactly. Yes. But she did say no rather quickly.
She did know what that meant. Yeah. But I've always
admired... Did she say, like, I'd love to have a lady pond in Montecito?
Yeah, right.
That would be lovely.
She kind of thought, what kind of flower is that? I'm not kidding.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, exactly. I'm not kidding.
It's a flower.
I'm not kidding. But the point I'm getting to is that these two have been long-term friends. You now have 2 children.
Yeah.
2 and 2. Are your kids close with you all, too?
They're buddies.
I'm curious about that.
They are buddies. And when we hang out...
Because I love that.
It's very sweet. I mean, and
they're basically the same. His oldest son is a little bit older than mine. So.
Yeah. He's a year older. And now they're in different schools and stuff.
This.
But we try to get them together. And, you know, part of the thing when you have young kids is that you're really just trying to pass the time. And so we have had a great deal of fun passing the time with our children.
What's the best thing and what's the worst thing about having 2 young kids?
For me, the best thing is just the love and the hugs and the, you know, and the glee at everything, you know, just, you know, him, the day of the eclipse, he kept saying, when is the eclipse, when is it going to be the eclipse? He kept saying, when is it going to be the eclipse? And just seeing things through his eyes.
The wonder through seeing it.
And also the worst them... is just the pain in the assness of it all that it can be.
Also seeing them together and develop a relationship with each other that's like separate from me and you know, their other dad, so.
I would like that.
So, Anderson, obviously your world is kind of crazy for the next, how you said, 209 days. 209 days.
Before the election. Not like, that anyone's counting.
Do you, like, obviously you say, I don't want to take my job home, but it's impossible with the chaos that we have going on right now. Do you ever just like, hey, you know what, can we just talk about issues and not talk about all the noise and the extracurricular stuff?
Yeah, sure. I mean, but it, you know, you can resolve not to talk about or even say the name, you know, the name that's out there. But, you know, it, inevitably, even people say, oh, you know what, we're not going to talk about this today, end up talking about it.
Yes.
And it, you can't, you know.
It's unavoidable.
I just, I've stopped trying to stop people from, in my private life, like, discussing it, because there's no point. No matter what, people come around and start talking about it.
Before you guys came, because all of us have done interviews, we pulled some clips from tense moments from our interviews.
Okay.
For each one of us. Oh. And so I'm curious about how you respond or how you would handle that now. Yeah, you'll get a kick out of this. Roll tape.
She talks a good game, but she doesn't do anything.
She has hatred or
her policies are bigoted. Her policies are bigoted because she knows they're not going to work.
But you're saying she is personally bigoted.
Oh, she is. Of course she is. Her policies, they're her policies.
Stop it. Y'all quit playing. Quit playing. I didn't do this stuff. This is not me. I'm fighting for my life. Y'all killing me with this.
Yes, she
did. You blame her for this?
Yes.
Louie, do you blame her for this?
Karma.
Hold on. Hold
on. I never want to see her friend again.
Shit!
You really just been working on your game, trying to get back your timing and condition, really, to be honest, correct?
Yeah.
Wow, I love
when
that.
I saw that,
I mean, I got an unfair edit there. I'm the only one losing my cool. I've done thousands of hours.
No, Andy,
and that's what you choose.
When I asked Kevin,
Andy, that was
when I asked Kevin that question, he gave me the one word response. Everybody was waiting on something else, and it was like 15 seconds. I'm like, Ernest, like, I don't think he's gonna say nothing else. And it was great TV. I mean, it was Gayle.
What?
But in fairness, yours was the best.
No.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I mean, that
yours
was
the best. All the memes of Gayle and R. Kelly.
No, but I thought yours was the best the way you went, fuck it! Because when that happens on television, you realize that you're kind of out of control in that moment.
Yes.
There's nothing you can do about it, true?
Yes. That was about 10 hours into it.
I know.
Listening to a lot of circular.
Do you like, in an interview like that with R. Kelly, do you like to spend time with the person beforehand to sort of try to develop some sort of rapport, or do you prefer to just come in cold?
I prefer to just come in cold.
Had you ever met him before?
No, I did go say hello to him.
Right. Okay.
And I had seen him at different events, but I can't say that we knew each other. But the thing that was so interesting is that, because I called the next day just to check on him, because I knew it had gone so off the rails, and they said, he wants to thank you for allowing people to see his passion and his pain.
Oh,
I go, is that what he saw that night?
And then what did he say after it aired?
Passion and pain. And this was after it aired.
Wow.
He was saying, that's what I said. Is that that's what he said?
Wow.
Okay.
Note to self, don't have delusional people around you.
Anderson, Andy, thank you so much. I know that you got a show. Anderson has a show, guys.
You got a job, Gayle.
So do I.
Oh, Andy got a show. Andy got a
tonight on Bravo, I'm in the clubhouse. Gerard Carmichael's on my show tonight.
Oh, wow. Yes. That's good.
Yes.
Tell him continued success.
He's got a great story.
I like him.
I love him.
I like him a lot.
I do, too.
That's a good guess.